Shalom, giving all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh Bahashim Yahushai, Bahashim Raka Kodash, double honors unto the apostles and the elders of the great millstone, peace and salutations unto the Akiam, the brothers pushing this truth through the four corners of the earth in truth and sincerity, risking their lives and their freedom to do so, now more so than ever, to the scattered elect that be scattered among the heathen who be like unto the speckled bird. I say Shalom, and I say Shalom unto the few and faithful Aqua, the few sisters, you know, listening and learning. This is your brother Yerushalom from the GMS Prophetic Vibrations Camp out of Trinidad and Tobago, coming at you with another video through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bahashim Yahushai Bahashim Raka Kodash. And this video is going to be entitled Taliban and the Women. Alright, so basically Taliban reinforcing the laws of the Lord, all right, because you know this is talking about these this recent spectacle that we saw take place in Afghanistan after the U.S. was forced to pull out, you know, because they lost the war, all right, you know. And as Apostle Tahas would have said in this video, you know, that's a sign. You know, because Afghanistan is considered to be the graveyard of empires. You know, when Russia went in there, as the USSR, United Soviet States of Russia, they came out and they broke up. Same thing is going to happen to America, all right? But I was watching this video here, what you see on screen, and, you know, they were making a few points about the, you know, when the Taliban is reassuming their power in Afghanistan. And the concerns of the women, you know, and the so-called, you know, women's right activists or campaigners, you know, who are really feminists, all right, you know, and their concerns over the Taliban and what and the policies that they're bringing back, you know, and the policies that they speak about in this video is nothing more than you know honoring the laws and the customs of Yahweh Bahashim Yahushai, of our heritage, because these Taliban are mainly Arabs, you know, Ishmaelites, all right, you know, and they would have had the customs of Abraham, who was their father, all right, so they would have that in common, you know, with us, all right, so this is nothing new that they're bringing, all right, it's just that this feminism and this wickedness, you know, that Esau, Edom bring through America, you know, in the conquest of the world, and the westernization, and, you know, and bringing the abominations, all right, the wicked abominations, like they are ABC people, all right, the feminism, all right, all these are plagues, all right, because the word woman really means servant, all right, so a woman is supposed to serve a man, right? You're serving your husband, your father, first of all, before you leave your father's house, you know. And then you'll serve your husband once you get married to your husband. Once your father chooses a man of understanding, fear, that's how it's supposed to be in our heritage. All right? And right now, Yahweh Bahashim Yahushai is giving us back our heritage. Okay? All right? Because our heritage was taken away by him, Jeremiah 17:4. All right? We are discontinued from our heritage, but now the Lord is giving us back. So, without further ado, let me get into this video here.
About Taliban as well. So the chaos and confusion continues there, and with tens of thousands of people in Kabul, with no one in charge of the country, they are worried about their future, their life, and what will happen to them next.
And Ambarasan, for those who remain in Afghanistan, there are reports that in some parts of the country, the Taliban are already enforcing changes to the way women dress, whether they're able to go to work. And in some cases, we hear they're turning them away from the gates of universities or schools.
You know, and all these things, these allowing women to go to work, all right, so-called educating them, which is really it's not the school system, it's the fool system, but they just train them to be what, a servant at Esau instead of a servant to your father or to your husband. All right, women just need to learn how to read and write, you know, they don't need anything much more than that. And you know, a lot of people wouldn't like this video, you know, wouldn't like this truth, all right, because you know, it teaches women, you know, to, it brainwashes women, all right, to focus on a career, you know, and being independent, right? Which a woman is not supposed to be independent, right? And to get up above her man. And this is what it's all about. This is what this whole wicked system, Esau wicked system, is about. Let me get a scripture here. Alright? Let me bring in a scripture here. This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 51, and verse 7. And actually, let me read from verse 6. It says, flee out of the midst of Babylon. Right? You know, and we, not all of us actually in Babylon, the Great, which is America, but you know, we in the lands where we scattered here, you know, most of them following after the Babylon the Great, right? In terms of their system, right? In terms of how they operating, right? You know, and deliver every man his soul, be not cut off in her iniquity, the sin. For this is the time of the Lord Yahbashim Yoshai's vengeance. He will render unto her recompense. So you don't want to be caught up in that recompense. And it's for all these women, you know, who hear this video. Alright? Don't get caught up in Babylon's system, right? Because verse 7 says, Babylon had been a golden cup in Yahbashim Yoshai's hand. Yeah, because the Lord is the one who gave them that power. Alright? That made all the earth drunken. You know, they're drunken with the false wicked philosophies that you saw, the wicked wine. You know, so-called wine. That's the philosophies of the, even this feminism. Alright? The nations have drunken of a wine, therefore the nations are mad. And this woman activist you're gonna hear in this video, they mad. Because really and truly, they want to follow after Babylon. You know, which is the way of destruction. But no, but America, Babylon it has been a golden cup in Lord's hand, because the Lord himself was the one who created feminism. Alright? It was created by the Most High on the left hand side. You know, to accomplish our curses, you know, to accomplish curses. Let me get something accomplished. Deuteronomy 28 and verse 56. You know, to raise up the woman to a high stature over the men. You know, which was to punish us. Deuteronomy 28 and 56 says, the tender and delicate woman among you, which would not adventure to set the sole of her foot upon the ground for delicateness and tenderness, her eyes shall be evil toward the husband of her bosom, and toward her son, and toward her daughter. And, you know, and this is as a punishment, you know, for us. Alright? Because the Lord allowed them to raise up very high. Alright? You know, the woman, Lord allowed a woman to compass a man. Jeremiah 31 and verse 22. It says, how long will thou go about, O backsliding daughter? For the Most High, Yahbashim Yahshai created a new thing in youth, a woman shall compass a man. So this feminism, which was created by the Lord in the left hand side through Esau Edom, alright, you know, you heard about, you know, about Francis Fanny, right? You know, in 1829 came with this agenda from the UK, you know, to preach, to lecture in America, right, on this, you know. And this was all to accomplish this prophecy, alright, that a new thing would be created. You know, this new because it's not, it wasn't sanctioned by the Most High initially. It's not in part of his law. But the Lord did it but to punish us. Alright? A woman shall compass a man, which means what? Get up above a man. Alright? And that's why her eye is gonna be was evil. Alright? That's why her eye become evil. But we'll see that shortly. Let's go back to the video.
Is there any clarity on what the policy is? And there are reports that in some parts of the country, the Taliban are already enforcing changes to the way women dress, to their, whether they're able to go to work. And
right. So the way women dress, you know, in this truth, the way women supposed to dress, right, is with sobriety. All right. Let me get some scriptures here. All right. This is 1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 9, right? It reads, in like manner also that women adorn themselves in modest apparel, just means unassuming, reserved. All right, you know, you can go into the word here, modest apparel means clothes.
Strong's G 2887 Cosmios, Thayer's Lexicon, related entry, Cosmios.
Right, well arranged, seemingly modest, good behavior. Right, so you're not dressing half naked. Alright, not scantily clad, you know, dressing with pants. Alright, which is an abomination in the sight of the Lord. Deuteronomy 21:5, a woman should not put on a man's garments. Alright, roughly paraphrasing. Alright, so you're dressing with modesty, modest apparel, right? Alright, with shamefacedness and sobriety, being shamefaced. Right, being shamefaced, why? Because you know, because of your father or your husband. Alright, with sobriety. Alright. Sobriety. It says soundness of mind, self-control. Right, not being loose. Alright. Not with broided hair or gold or pearls or costly. So you're not supposed to be seeing all those things, right? So a woman's head supposed to be covered in the first place. Alright? You know, and that's part of the scriptures too. A woman's head is supposed to be covered. That's in, I believe it's 1 Corinthians. Let's get that. 1 Corinthians 11. Yeah, 1 Corinthians 11 and 5. But every woman that prayed or prophesied with her head uncovered dishonored her head. For that is even all one as if she was shaven. Alright, so it's a shame for a woman to be shaven. Alright. So women ought not to cover their head. Alright. Verse 6 says, for if a woman be not covered, let her also be shorn. So she should shave off her head then. But if it be a shame for a woman to be shorn or shaven, let her be covered, and it is a shame. Alright. And we know that the man is not of the woman, you know, but the woman is of the man. Neither was the man created for the woman, but the woman for the man. For this cause ought the woman to have power on her head because of the angels. Alright, so a woman have to cover her head. Alright, just to cover her head when she praying, and even generally speaking. Alright, her head should be covered. Alright, because you can be praying at any point in time. Alright, Lord say pray without ceasing. Alright, so if that means that your head should be covered, alright, you need to take that off for your husband. So show you how wicked this place is. Alright? You know, and in terms of the dress too, we talk about as he went on, he spoke about the burqa. Alright. Woman wearing something called a burqa. Right, which is like this here, a typed in burqa versus hijab. Burqa is basically a cloth, a black cloth. It covers your whole body and leaves just your eyes open. Now this is not unfamiliar from the scriptures, because when we read in the scriptures, we see that Rebecca, she covered her face with a veil too. Alright, Genesis chapter 24 and verse 64. It says, and Rebekah lifted up her eyes, and when she saw Isaac, she lighted off the camel. For she had said unto the servant, what man is this that walketh in the field to meet us? And the servant had said, it is my master. Therefore she took her veil and covered herself. Right, she covered up her face. Because if you're going to go to a veil, a veil means it's a covering for your face. Alright, so just her face was open, but her head would have been covered. Alright. You know, so there's nothing strange. No, a woman's supposed to really cover her face. The ancestors knew why they were doing that. You know, especially for instances where they want women to go to schools and work, because these places are places of adultery, places of wickedness. Alright? That's basically what they are. Alright? Let's continue with the video here.
In some cases, we hear they're turning them away from the gates of universities or schools. Is there any clarity on what the policy is and whether it's going to be applied cohesively across the country, or does it vary from region to region?
I think the country is now at a point of transformation. Even the Taliban are now gradually taking over control. For example, they have started their own radio broadcast, and they're converting the state broadcasters into, you know, Taliban broadcast. And
so it's a transformation, right? Back to the way things supposed to be. all right, for away from the occupation of the wicked, which is Esau, Edom, and their evil philosophies, all right, where women go into work, which is a big problem. You know, I've seen in my experience, you know, many women, you know, basically whoring themselves, all right, prostituting themselves in the workplace, you know. And what the Lord said, a woman is not to guard abroad. All right, these places, these women develop feelings for men who they work around. You know, the Lord says, sit not much with a man's wife. All right, sit not much. In fact, let me see if I can get that. Sit not much with. Yeah, Sirach 9:9. Yeah, so because the Lord said, don't sit down with a man's wife, all right? And this is what happens every day in the workplace. Let's get Sirach 9, only 9, verse. All right, Sirach 9 and 8, it says, turn away thine eye from a beautiful woman. This is why woman's face should be covered. You know, to reduce the lust and the temptation, right? And look not upon another's beauty, for many have been deceived by the beauty of a woman. For herewith love is kindled as a fire. So, you know, if you're not seeing that in the face of a woman, then you, and the shape of a woman, you know, you're not going to have that lust. You know, you're not going to have that fire, all right? That cause problems, you know, because sometimes there's another man's wife, all right? Which leads on to adultery. You know, and adultery starts in your mind. All right, just sit in your mind first. This is Sirach 9:9. Sit not at all with another man's wife, nor sit down with her in thine arms. All right, so don't sit next to another man's wife. But this happens every day. You know, some men are seated right next to women and they work together. All right, and spend not thy money at her at the wine. You know, and a lot of them go to lunch together. I've seen that. You know, I've seen, you know, these work affairs, right? You know, least thine heart incline unto her, and so thorough thy desire thou fall into destruction. But that's what adultery leads to, destruction. You know, sin leads to death. All right, you know, plus the Lord said what, a woman is not supposed to guard abroad. Let's get that. That's in Sirach as well. Sirach chapter 25 and verse, I believe, is it only 24th verse. Sirach 25 and 24, it says, of the woman came the beginning of sin, and through her we all die. So that's why women are the weaker vessel. You know, I think it's from the scripture. All right, so you don't leave a woman, you know, to guard abroad, which means to roam around the place. All right, to roam on her own, to be independent, right? Sirach 25 and 24, of the woman came the beginning of sin, and through her we all die. Give the water no passage, neither a wicked woman liberty, freedom, right? Independence, that's what that means, to guard abroad. If she go not as thou wouldest have her, cut her off from thy flesh and give her a bill of divorce and let her go. Right? So this is how serious it is. Alright? Especially in this time. You know, this is no joke. Alright? Sirach 26 and verse 8. It says, a drunken woman and a gatherer abroad causeth great anger. Yeah, because, you know, if you're drunken, you become loose. A woman is loose. Alright? And when a woman roam her body place, she is looking for problem. All different type of men will be running after her. You know, because most of them time they dress provocatively, not modestly. All right, you know, with the skin showing, you know, half the ass hanging out, all right, the breast cleavage showing, all right, which is wrong. All right, so when this is happening, when the Taliban is doing Israeli righteousness, all right, a drunken woman and a gather abroad cause that create anger, and she will not cover her own shame. All right, she's not going to cover her own, she's not going to cover her body. Right, that's why the Lord said he would discover the secret parts in Isaiah 2 chapter. Right? Because the Lord is really the one who made our woman fall to this low level. It's a low level. Alright? It's evil and wickedness, right? Verse 9 says, the whoredom of a woman may be known in her haughty looks and eyelids. Right? Because why? Right? Because she be looking around all over the place. Alright? She be looking around with wanton eyes. Alright? It says, if thy daughter be shameless, keep her in straitly, which means what? Give her difficulty to go her own way. Alright? Lest she abuse herself through overmuch liberty. Right? So though, you know, women will abuse themselves if you don't keep them in straitly. Alright? Watch over an impudent eye, which a disrespectful eye, right? And marvel not if she trespass against you. So, you know, this is so real, all right? This is so real. You know, and what did the Lord say? You know, what did the Lord say? Let's get Isaiah, the 3rd chapter, and verse 16. Verse says, more of what the Lord said, Yahubashim Yahushai said, because the daughters of Zion are haughty, which means proud. All right, and we know what the Lord said happens to the proud. The prideful will be destroyed. All right, you know, they're haughty, they're mean. Right, they full of themselves. Right, they look down on men. Right, and walk with stretched forth necks and wanton eyes, looking at every single man. All right, walking and mincing as they go, and making a tinkling with their feet. All right, and this is what Babylon teaches the woman to be haughty. Right, to feel like they equal with a man, they can treat a man anyhow, and this is so untrue. All right, and I did videos before on that. All right, this was done for our curse, right? But the time of our curse is coming to an end. All right, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai Bashem Rakakodash. Now let's get Jeremiah. I think I get that one already. Actually, let me get Proverbs. Let's get Book of Proverbs, chapter 30, and verse 20. You know, and this is describe these women in the workplace, right? Who are allowed to go to work, right? You know, and also those women who in the schools, you know, these universities, which are really whorehouses, right? Women sleep with multiple men. When they go in, their body count, you know, just rises rapidly. Alright, when they come out, they might be slept with over 20, 30, 40 men. Alright, Proverbs 30 and 20. Such is the way of an adulterous woman. She eateth and wipeth her mouth, right? And said, I have done no wickedness. Alright, so that's what these women do. Right? They commit adultery with other men and they wipe their mouth, in which the mouth is not speaking about the one where they eat from. Alright, it's the other mouth. You know, and said, I have done no wickedness. But you have. All right, so let's get back to Sirach 26 and verse 12. It says, Sirach 26 and 12, she will open her mouth as a thirsty traveler when he had found a fountain, all right, and drink of every water near, yeah, every seed bag, all right. You know, she'll be jumping on the cock carousel, going round and round with man after man, all right. That's what happens in the workplace and in those schools. Those so-called schools that Esau set up, all right? By every hedge will she sit down and open a quiver against every arrow and every rod, you know? Many different men going inside them, which devalues a woman and makes her of a low value, a low status, all right? You know? Is that this is how important it is for a woman to be chaste, all right? And that's why these rules that they're bringing back, you know, that the Taliban is bringing back, you know, obviously, you know, for righteousness. All right, now let me get back to that video here.
And moving into government offices and putting their own people, and many government officers, they just simply fled fearing reprisals. When I spoke to the Suhail Shaheen, the Taliban spokesman, and he denied all the charges about, you know, women being abused, and he said yes, women can go to universities, but with certain rules, like wearing the full veil with the burqa, and they would be allowed to be educated.
Yeah, the full veil with the burqa, and you know, and that's right, because we didn't know what wickedness would happen, right, according to what the laws, according to heritage, right?
But again, if the reports are true, what coming from the Taliban-controlled areas, that nothing much has changed from what they were doing between 1996 and 2001. Even about the executions and the people being forced out of their homes, and many people are simply shot dead because they were part of the security forces. So these kind of accusations are still there, but the Taliban, they continue to keep denying this.
Okay, Ambarasan, thank you very much indeed for the update on that. Ambarasan Natarajan there, monitoring developments from Delhi. Well, I'm joined now from Afghanistan by a prominent women's rights campaigner who does not wish to reveal her identity. thank you for speaking to us here on BBC News. What is the situation for women and girls today as they wake up in Afghanistan?
Unfortunately, the today's situation in Afghanistan is exactly taking us to the dark age of Taliban while they were controlling Afghanistan at their time.
And they're talking about it, and you see, you hear the wickedness of this woman, right? She already start off wrong, talking about how, you know, the Taliban had them in the dark ages, the women in dark ages. They had them in under control, and that's what the women don't like. All right, these women don't like it. But that's the way it's supposed to be. And that's the way it's going to be in the kingdom. All right, just that you're going to be in the right mind, you women of Israel are going to be in the right mind. You know, you're not going to have a problem with it. All right?
And unfortunately, it's also the same rules that they came when they promised in Doha. They didn't fulfill their promises. They attacked, they stopped women in most of the provinces from school and universities. Although publicly they announced that women and girls are allowed to go to school and university, but when it comes to the reality, they close the door for the university and schools for women. When it comes to the women, big pictures on the walls of the beauty salons or anywhere else, they ordered that they should be either taken out or their faces need to be covered. And again, they order a special kind of code for the women. And that's quite similar to burqa or either a long black dress, which is just only eyes can be showing.
Which is what I showed you in the picture. Right here. Alright, something like this. Alright. Notice they can't see the shape of the woman, you know, and this, but the one on the left, all right, you know, you can't see the eyes, you can only see the eyes, all right, and that's for a reason, you know, not to encourage lust, all right, you know, and she was talking about the schools, you know, but as I explained earlier, you know, they don't want any woman to think that, you know, they higher than any men, and that's what happens when women are so-called educated, you know, first of all, women focus on their career, they want to be independent, they want to get up above the man, you know, they end up, you know, earning more money than the man, all right, then they end up controlling the whole scene, you know, which causes problems in the home, in the family, all right, which causes families to break up, all right, so this is the devil's whole plan, all right, especially for us as Hebrew Israelites, all right, this is the book of Sirach chapter 25 and verse 22. It says, a woman, if she maintain her husband, is full of anger, impudence, which means disrespectfulness and rudeness, and much reproach. So she have a lot of times women make more money than men, and this is what happens in the home. So the man can't be a man in the home, right, which causes the whole family to break up, right? A wicked woman abates at the courage, making a heavy countenance, right? A man looks sorrowful, right, and a wounded heart, which is a mind. A woman that will not comfort her husband in distress make it weak hands and feeble knees. So these women, and the workplace creates that, the school system and the workplace creates women like that, all right, which is which destroys our nation, all right. You know what the Lord, you know, really meant for a woman to be, you know, is this, let me see verse 13, Sirach 26 and 13 says, the grace of a woman delighteth her husband, and her discretion will fatten his bones. All right, her being graceful, you know, being chaste, all right, a silent and loving woman is a gift of them of the Lord. But you know, these school systems and workplace create women who clamorous, who loud, you know, and the Lord doesn't like a woman like that. Lord loves a silent and a loving woman. A silent and a loving woman is a gift of the Lord, and there's nothing so much worth as a mind well instructed, right? A shamefast and faithful woman is a double grace, and her continent mind cannot be valued. That continent goes into what? Exercising self-restraint, you know, especially sexually, all right? Not opening her quiver to every arrow, right? You know? This is how serious this is. All right, as the sun, when it ariseth in the high heaven, so is the beauty of a good wife in the ordering of her house. And that's where a woman really should be. You know, a woman should be keeping the house according to scriptures. All right, you shouldn't be outside there with a lot of men. All right, and in school, it's the same thing. All right, it just encourages wickedness. Okay, now jump back into the video and then close it off with a few scriptures.
This is just the beginning. This is, I think they don't want to really show their real face at the moment. But I believe when time comes, their real face will come up and they will again ask for their own same rules. Even when it comes to security, I think yesterday there was a lot of case of organized crime, target terror, and of course Taliban was searching for those prominent people that they were having on their hit list before. So that has made life more difficult for women. Women in Afghanistan, especially women's rights activists, are really feeling themselves. First, we've been badly betrayed by international community, because, and also by Taliban, because Taliban said they...
Yeah, you've been really betrayed by international community, not Taliban, because America came and set up the wickedness, you all know, in the wickedness, and so now we turn back to righteousness, you feel in some kind of way, all right?
Will not enter to Kabul city, which is unfortunately they did. They say they will respect women, but unfortunately in practice, they did something totally different.
No, and she's wrong on that, because she's respecting women as being equal to men, and women are not equal to men according to the scriptures. Woman was created as a help meet to a man. You get that in Genesis chapter 2. All right, you know, you get a divine order in 1 Corinthians. In fact, let me go there. Let's get that. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 11. All right. And verse 2. Now I praise you, brethren, that you remember me in all things and keep the ordinances as I deliver them to you. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Yahmashiach, which is Yahweh Shai, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Yahmashiach is the Most High. So women are under the man. Are they under your father? Or if you're in your father's house still, or you're under your husband. All right, but you're definitely under a man. All right? Because a woman is really the possession of a man. All right? A woman is a possession. Which is a, you know, and you know, a lot of people wouldn't be able to accept that. A lot of women wouldn't be able to accept that. That's why the Lord only dealing with the elect of Israel. All right? Who's going to turn back in these times, right? This is Sirach 36 and verse 24. It says, he that getteth a wife beginneth a possession. Right? A possession, something that you own. Right? A help like unto himself, which going back to Genesis 2, right? And a pillar of rest. Right? Where no hedge is, there the possession is small. So if you don't put a hedge around your wife or around your daughter, you know that possession gonna be spoiled. You're gonna be spoiled by the wicked philosophies of Esau, Edom, you know, the devil. Alright? You know, and he that have no wife will wander up and down mourning, right? Because the Lord created a woman to help a man. Alright? And a woman's supposed to submit herself unto her husband. Alright? And that's thus says the Lord. Ephesians 5 and verse 22. It says, wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife. Right? Even as Hamashiach Yehovah Shai is the head of the church. And he is the savior of the body. So the man, women are really saved. And in this time too, the women are really going to be saved by their husbands, by their future husbands. Whether you have a man or not, you know, in this time in Jacob's trouble, you know, when all shit pops off, all hell breaks loose. Alright? You know, in the kingdom, you're not going to have no independent woman. You're going to have a husband. Alright? And right now, if your husband will be a man of the Lord, either he's one of the 144,000, or he'll be one of the elect men, you know, one of the 144,000 who doing this work, right? And by doing this work, you know, he's saving you, all right? you know? So he's the savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Yahweh Shai Mashiach, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Right? Everything. He didn't say some things, right? In everything, you're supposed to be submissive to your husband. You're supposed to obey him. Alright? This is how real it is. Alright? So don't let feminism get the best of you. You know, in this time, you gotta break free of those chains of feminism. Right? It will only destroy you.
They say they will not start their own Taliban types rules and regulation and laws that they had during 1996, but we are...
No, you know, they need to implement those rules, right? Because a woman needs to live under rules, right? Where there's no hedge, the possession is spoiled, all right? You know, and that's how real it is. And so in this time, women need to wake up, all right, and seek Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai in spirit and in truth, not the lies you've been told, all right? It might be a hard pill to swallow at first, but hey, it is what it is, and this is what's coming, right? Isaiah 32 and 9, it says what? Rise up, you women that are at ease, hear my voice, ye careless daughters. Give ear unto my speech. Many days and years shall ye be troubled, ye careless women. For the vintage shall fail, and the gathering shall not come. So all these women who are at ease in the system, they need to raise up quick. They need to rise up quick and change their ways, right? Verse 11 says, tremble, ye women that are at ease, be troubled, ye careless ones. Strip you and make you bare, and good sackcloth upon your loin. And this is what's going to happen in this time coming up here. Jacob's trouble, right? Women are going to be brought low, right? Isaiah 32 and 12, they shall lament for the teats, which were the pleasant things of this kingdom. Alright, the government programs. Alright, you know, all the benefit things that you could go to any city and buy and have yourself looking nice. Alright, your makeup, your hair, your weaves. Alright, your clothes. Alright, all those things going to be taken away. Alright? You know, and if you have a problem with your Abashim, your Shai law, alright, and this truth, what I'm telling you, you're going to be destroyed. Proverbs 13 and 13. Alright, if you have a problem with this, Proverbs 13 and verse 13, it says, whoso despiseth the word shall be destroyed, but he that feareth the commandment shall be rewarded. So that's the difference between the elect woman and the two-thirds woman. You know, the elect are going to cleave to the law and cleave to the men of the Lord, whereas the two-thirds, they're going to despise this law and be destroyed. Alright? Isaiah 3 and verse 25. It reads, thy men shall fall by the sword, and thy mighty in the war. So this is what's going to happen to you. Your men going to die. Your men, your fiancés, all of them going to die. Right? Go back to 2 Ezra 16 and 33. Same thing, right? And her gates shall lament and mourn. She going to be, you're going to have no man to take care of you. You don't have your leadership. You're going to be gone. Your protection going to be gone. Your hedge is going to be gone. All you say, you don't need a man. You know, you'll see in those times how much you need a man, especially a man of the Lord. You know, and she being desolate shall sit upon the ground. You're going to be desolate, right? You're going to be trodden down, right? Just like they say in the scripture, in the book of Micah 7 and verse 10, all those who scoff at this word, all those women, Micah 7 and 10 says, Then she that is my enemy shall see it. What she going to see? She'll see the power of the Lord. She's going to see how the Lord is going to raise up his men, right? And shame shall cover her, which said unto me, where is Yahweh thy power? Because they mock us. You know, they look down on the men of the Lord, right? You know? But in that time, you know, the Lord is going to make us shine, right? Where is Yahweh thy power? Mine eyes shall behold her, right? Now shall she be trodden down as the mire in the streets. You know, mire is dirt, maybe filth. Right, that's a woman going to be trodden down. They're not going to be smelling good. They're not going to be looking good. Right? They're going to be hungry. They're going to be in a mess. They're going to be raped. Right? Men are going to be raping you. All these two-third niggas that, you know, you like hanging around. A lot of them are going to be taking turns raping you, gang raping you. Right? This is what's coming. Right? What you saw in Book of Eli. Right? And only the men of the Lord going to be raised up. Alright? Let me see if I get that scripture. A man covered from the tempest. You saw plainly full with my phone here, but from the Isaiah 3:2, so the men of the Lord, you know, are gonna be like this. It's Isaiah 3:2, it says, and a man shall be as a hiding place from the wind of the destruction, right? Especially ICBM nuclear destruction that's coming, right? And a covered from the tempest, a covering from the tempest, right? From all the things that the plagues that the Lord gonna bring on this place, right? As rivers in of water in a dry place, as a shadow of a great rock in a weary land, you know, when it's hot and dry and the desert conditions, you know, the men of the Lord are gonna be like this to you women. Alright, the men of the Lord, not those two-third, you know, ninjas, right? Alright? That's how real it is. This is why you have to get yourself in order now and humble yourself. Alright? You know, don't be like these feminists, right? Humble yourself. So with that, you know, I pray this lesson was edifying through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. I give all praises, honor, and glory and power unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Raka Kodash. Double honors unto the apostles and the elders of the great millstone. Peace and salutations unto the hopeful elect, Wabad Babal, and Shalom.